Oh, it's that time of year again already? Guess I'm talking about crabs.
This just in. The Christmas Island red crab ladies dropped 100,000 crab babies into the ocean on the 20th of January, so you can bet your butt we're on Baby Crab Watch 2020. We have almost one more week to go before thousands of baby crabs march back into the jungles of Christmas Island.
But most are probably going to get eaten along the way. That's just nature. Anyway, this year I'm talking about another kind of crab. One that I have yet to find in the wilds of New York City's dollar oyster deals. Although I'm sure it's just a matter of time. But first, let's talk about oysters. Century satirist Jonathan Swift is often quoted as saying he was a bold man that first ate an oyster. Well, joke's on him. There's evidence at Pinnacle Point in South Africa that early humans ate mussels, oysters, even salvaged whale as early as 164,000 years ago. So, sir, eating oysters is old hat for us. In Japan, oysters have been cultivated since 2000 BC. In fact, Hiroshima Bay was famous for its oyster production by the 16th century. Ancient Romans, also big oyster aficionados. We know the Mayans used oyster shells in construction, which is why you don't find large deposits of shell like you do in, say, New York. And talking of New York, there's evidence of oyster consumption as early as 6950 BC. In fact, the Dobbs Ferry oyster minnow is the earliest evidence of humans in the Hudson Valley. Did you know New York City used to be called the Big Oyster, and our homegrown oysters were sold across the world? Until overfishing and pollution destroyed the oyster beds. But don't worry, the Billion Oyster Project's on it. Take Staten Island and the Living Breakwaters Project. The plan is to incorporate new oyster beds, or oystertecture. It's architecture using oysters. To help protect against future storm surges. Which, if you happen to be living in New York City during Hurricane Sandy... Yes, please! Here are some of my favorite oyster facts. A single oyster can filter 20 to 50 gallons of water a day. Know who else eats oysters? Starfish! The R-month rule, that was a thing before refrigeration. Although oysters spawn in the summer, so I just think they taste better in the winter anyway, so there! Oysters are really easy to farm! Sustainability! Except for where pollution's killing them off, like in the Puget Sound. They are NOT an aphrodisiac! I don't care how much they look like certain bits. They are, however, low in fat, cholesterol, and calories, while being high in things like protein, calcium, omega-3 fatty acids, zinc, iron, vitamin C. That being said, you'd have to eat upwards of 250 oysters to meet your daily caloric need. And as someone who once ate 36 oysters in a single sitting, like my name was Lillian Russell and I was trying to one-up Diamond Jim Brady in a Gilded Age restaurant, well... 36 raw oysters is my limit, thanks. Nella? How do you know so much about oysters? Well, other Nella, it comes down to the best laid plans of mice and Nellas. See, years ago I thought, ooh, I should do a podcast. A podcast about food. I'll call it, Are You Gonna Eat That? A history of things humanity probably shouldn't have put in their mouths, but did anyway. I commissioned theme music. There was artwork. I researched and recorded two whole episodes before I crumpled like wet tissue paper and walked away from it forever. It was really too much pressure. But in what would have been my oyster episode, I discovered something. Now for anyone who shucks their own oysters, I'm sure you know all about this already, so... good on you. But I pay someone a whole dollar to shuck them for me, and I had no idea. that hidden within the shell of the oyster, sitting in the gills, eating just enough filtered crap for survival while only lightly stunting the oyster's growth, lies the oyster crab. Or pea crab, depending on the species. So pea crabs or oyster crabs are like pearls. If pearls were crabs with legs and were red and were crunchy, it's a surprise they have in common. These tiny kleptoparasitic crustaceans grow to about the size of a penny, and because they're protected by the oyster shell, they remain soft and translucent. Female oyster crab larvae attach to the oyster spat and live their entire lives inside the oyster, while the male oyster crabs have to fend for themselves on the outside. But if the ladies stay inside the shell their whole lives, how do they mate? Well, according to one website, the male pea crab will rub the edge of the shellfish for hours until the shellfish finally opens up and lets him in. That poor oyster. Unless, you know, the oyster's into it or something. I mean, who am I to judge? According to How to Cook Shellfish by Olive Green, oyster crabs are small animals who live on oysters. They move in like relatives and make themselves at home in the oyster shell, or cling to the outside in case the apartment is full. The oysters probably regard them as a Saint Bernard looks upon his fleas, but this is not certain, as the oysters are too polite to speak about it. These hanger-ons of oysters make very good eating when properly cooked. It would be a kindness to oysters if oyster crabs were more generally eaten. So there are crabs. Yep. And they live in oysters. Yep. And this is common. Yep. In fact, the Grand Central Oyster Bar claims to toss out 1,000 a day. And you can eat them. A resounding yep. In fact, there are oodles of ways to prepare them. 10 ways to cook oyster crabs. Fried oyster crabs. 1. Fried oyster crabs. 2. Mayonnaise of oyster crabs. Oyster crabs on toast. Oyster crabs a la Newberg. Oyster crabs a la Poulette. Oyster crabs a la Hollandaise. Oyster crabs a la Boston. Oyster crabs a la Rennes. Oyster crab saute. Fricasseed oyster crabs. Yes, according to the 1907 New York Times article, oyster crabs were a rare delicacy. But hey, you could always just eat them raw. But are they good? Allegedly, they're amazing. A condensed version of crab, like getting punched in the mouth by umami. Nella, you disgust me. I didn't sign up for crabs in my oysters. That's what she said. Look, you're already eating a live oyster. Swallowing it whole. Your gaping maw slurping down the liquor within it, sliding down your throat along with the mucus-like organs, unchewed. Your only disillusion in the foaming sea of stomach acid below awaits it. So the next time you go out for dollar oysters, tell the waiters to leave the crabs on the side. Be the cruel omnivore that nature intended. Eat those raw oysters. Crunch on those oyster crabs. After all, it's a delicacy. Or you could just never eat an oyster again. Or something. A shout out to my earlenders. Avi Finkel, Chandra, Johan Gustafsson, William Christopher, and Xanthan Pink. As ever, thank you so much for your continued support at this level. And it's that time again! Postcards! This postcard is from the Netherlands. Groeten uit Utrecht. I find that funny because my parents went to New Utrecht High School in Brooklyn. Dear Nella, I'm pleased to be able to send you a postcard from a technically non-Anglophone country. Now that I'm learning Dutch, I enjoy hearing you mention all of the Dutch-derived names in and around New York. thank you for your consistently entertaining explanations of things, and I hope they keep bringing you joy for a long time to come, Danielle. Thank you so much, Danielle, for your postcard from the Netherlands. This is delightful. There are so many sunflowers, as you can see on the postcard. If you would like to send me a postcard that I can read out loud at the end of my videos, details below for the P.O. box, and until next time. Whoa. Girl cat, that's not for you. That's not for you. Oh, it's boy cat this time. Well, now you're coming here. Oh, I got him.
You did.
Joy, I got him. Look at him. Look at this floppy eared boy. Oh, he had a hematoma on his ear, and now he's a floppy ear. He has a floppy ear for the rest of his life. He had such beautiful bat ears, and now he doesn't. But it's so cute. It's so cute. Mother, I have more dignity than this. Don't show me off to your friends. Oyster crams a la hollandaise. Oyster crams a la cat.